move on and we'll begin working on the sleeves, and we'll begin with the right sleeve first of all. For the sleeves, we'll be using our J crochet hook, which is 6 millimeters, and we'll be using this hook from now on. So come to the underarm section, and at the underarm we made 5 half double crochets into the chain 5. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. We're going to attach the yarn after the 4th stitch. So in the space here, in between the 4th and the 5th stitch, we'll attach our yarn. And then make a chain of 2, 1 and 2. We're then going to work 1 half double crochet into the next 23 spaces. So into the next 23 spaces, we'll work 1 half double crochet. So the next space is in here. So there's 1,2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 19. And then I've arrived at the underarm section, so into this space here, number 20. In between these 2 stitches, number 21. And 23. And the chain 2, this is where we attached our yarn. Here's the chain 2. So to join the round, we're going to slip stitch in between, in the space between the chain 2 and the first half double crochet. So at the end of round number 1, you should have your chain 2 and then 23 half double crochet. For round number 2, begin by chaining 2, 1 and 2, and then turn your work. And it's important that you remember to turn your work at the end of each round. We're then going to make a decrease. And to make a decrease, we're going to do a half double crochet 2 together. And we'll be making this decrease over the next 2 spaces. So this is the first space here and then the second space. So to make the half double crochet 2 together, yarn over hook, insert your hook into the first space here, yarn over and pull up a loop. You'll have 3 loops on your hook. Yarn over, insert your hook into the next space. Yarn over, pull up a loop. You'll have 5 loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through all 5 loops. And this is the half double crochet 2 together. And then we're going to work 1 half double crochet into the next 19 spaces. So 1, 2, 3, and 19. And you should have 2 spaces remaining. So 1 and 2. The space here, this is where the chain 2 is coming from. So this is not your last space. It's these two here. And over these last 2 spaces, we'll work 1 half double crochet 2 together. So yarn over hook, insert your hook into the next space. Yarn over, pull up a loop. Yarn over, insert your hook into the following space. Yarn over, pull up a loop. And then yarn over and pull through all 5 loops on your hook. And then we'll join the round. So we have the chain 2 here and the first half double crochet 2 together. So into the space between the chain 2 and the stitch here, we'll make a slip stitch. And at the end of round 2, you should have your chain 2 and 21 half double crochets. For round number 3, chain 2, and turn your work. And we'll begin this round with another decrease. So we'll be working over the next 2 spaces. So the first space is in here, and the second space is in here after this half double crochet 2 together. So we'll make the half double crochet 2 together. And then we're going to work 1 half double crochet into the next 17 spaces. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, and 17. And then you should have 2 spaces remaining, 1 and 2. The space here, again, this is where the chain 2 is coming from, so this is not your last space. Over these last 2 spaces, we'll work another half double crochet 2 together. And then to join the round, we'll come to the space between the chain 2 and the first half double crochet 2 together here. So we'll join with a slip stitch. And at the end of round number 3, you should have your chain 2 and 19 half double crochet. For round 4, this is the last decrease round. Chain 2, 1 and 2. Turn your work. And we'll make 1 half double crochet 2 together over the first 2 spaces. So this is the first space and then the second space. And then we're going to work 1 half double crochet into the next 17 spaces. One, two, three, and 17. And this 17th stitch is made into the last space. So we're only doing a half double crochet two together at the beginning. And then to join the round, we're going to slip stitch into the space between the chain two and this half double crochet two together. So at the end of round four, you should have your chain two and 18 half double crochet. For round five, and this is the round that you're going to be repeating for the remainder of your little sleeve. So chain two, one and two, turn your work, and then you're going to work one half double crochet into the next 18 spaces. So the first space is here. So there's one, two, three, four, and 18. And then to join the round, we'll slip stitch into the space here between the chain two and the first half double crochet. So at the end of round five, you should have your chain two and 18 half double crochet. So you can see the little sleeve starting to form here. For rounds 6 to 16, you're going to repeat round number 5. I'm going to do this off camera and I'll meet you once I've finished round number 16. Once you've finished round number 16, just cut your yarn and fasten off and then weave your little ending. And then once you've weaved your ending, just turn the sleeve up to create a little cuff. We'll move on now and we'll begin working on the left sleeve. And you'll work this sleeve in exactly the same manner as the right sleeve. The only difference is where you'll attach the yarn, which I'll show you now. So to begin working on the left sleeve, we'll come to the underarm area. And we have our 5 half double crochet, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. We'll attach our yarn after the 4th stitch. So here's the 4th stitch and the 5th stitch. We'll attach our yarn in the space between these 2 stitches. And then you'll chain two, one and two. And then you're going to follow the same pattern for the left sleeve as you did for the right sleeve. I'm going to work the left sleeve off camera and I'll meet you once I've completed my left sleeve. As you can see, I've finished the left sleeve. And it's now time to move on and begin working on our little hood. And to do this, we'll come to the left-hand side of our cardigan and we'll attach our yarn into the top corner here. So into the top corner here, into the first space, I'm going to attach my yarn. And then make a chain of two, one and two, and then turn your work. And then into the first space here, I'm going to work one half double crochet. And then I'm going to work one half double crochet into the next three spaces. So there's one. Two. And three. And then I've arrived at the increase. This is where we did the half double crochet, chain two, and the half double crochet all into the same stitch. So into this space here, I'm going to work two half double crochet. So there's one, and then back into the same space, another half double crochet. And then I'm going to continue working one half double crochet into the next eight spaces until I get to the next increase. So there's one. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. And then into the next space, I'm going to work two half double crochet. So there's one, and then another one back into the same space. And then I'm going to work one half double crochet into the next 11 spaces, all the way along to the next increase. So there's one, two, three, and 11. And then into the next space here, where we worked our increase, I'm going to work two half double crochet. So there's one, and then another one back into the same space. And then I'm going to work one half double crochet into the next eight spaces, all the way along to the next increase. There's one. Two, three, and eight. And then into the next space, which is our increase that we made in row one, We'll work 2 half double crochet. So there's one and then another one back into the same space. And then we should have 1, 2, 3, and 4. 4 spaces left. So into these 4 spaces, I'll work 1 half double crochet. There's 1, 2, 3, and 4. So at the end of row number one, you should have your chain 2 at the beginning, and then you should have 43 half double crochets. For row number 2, and this is the row that you're going to be repeating for the remainder of your hood, begin by chaining 2, turn your work, and then into the first space, work 1 half double crochet. And then for the rest of row 2, you're simply going to work 1 half double crochet into the next 42 spaces. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, and 42. So at the end of row number 2, you should have your chain 2 at the beginning, and you should have 43 half double crochet. And I just want to point out that when you come to the part where we worked 2 half double crochet, make sure that you go in between those 2 stitches. It might be easy to think that was just 1 stitch, but you have to, there's a space in there and you have to work your half double crochet in there. For rows 3 to 17, you're going to repeat row number 2. So really easy. I'll work this off camera, and once I've finished row number 17, I'll meet you and we'll sew the hood together. I've just finished row number 17, so here's my completed hood. What you're going to do now is you'll cut your yarn, leaving a long tail for sewing. So I normally do it one length and then twice the length, and that should be enough for sewing the hood together. And then I'm just going to pull the yarn through. And then grab your tapestry needle, weave the end through, and we're now ready to sew the hood. And to sew the hood, you want to make sure that the right side is facing you. So this is the right side of our little cardigan, and we'll be sewing it like this. So we have the yarn coming out on this side here. Come over to the opposite side, and we have the chain 2, 1 and 2, and then the next stitches here, and this is the top of that stitch, we'll insert our needle through the top of the chain two. So one and two, we'll insert our needle through here, pull the yarn through, and that's both sides connected. And then what we're going to do to seam the hood together, we'll be using the whip stitch. And we'll be working on this side. We'll be working through the front loops. So these are the front loops here. And then on the opposite side, we'll be working through the back loops. So these are the back loops. These are the front loops. And these are the back loops. So the front loops on this side and the back loops on the opposite side. So come over to the first stitch on this side. Insert your needle through the front loop. Pull the yarn through. And then come to the first stitch on the opposite side and insert your needle through the back loop. So here's the front, we'll be inserting it through the back. Pull the yarn through and then move over to the next stitch. Insert your needle under the front loop, then come over to the next stitch on the opposite side and insert your needle through the back loop. And pull the yarn through. Move over to the next stitch. Insert your needle under the front loop. And then come over to the stitch on the opposite side. And insert your needle under the back loop. Pull the yarn through. And this is the manner in which we'll be working all the way along to the end. I'll do it one more time. Come over to the next stitch. Insert your needle under the front loop. And then move over to the next stitch on the opposite side. Insert your needle under the back loop. Pull the yarn through. So work your whip stitch all the way along to the end, and I'll do this off camera and I'll meet you once I've finished seaming the hood. I've just finished seaming the hood together. So this is what it looks like. And then once you come to the end, you're just going to thread the tail through your needle, and I'm just going to pop it through to the inside of the hood, and I'm just going to weave this little tail in. So that's me finished my little hood, and I decided to roll it back to create a little brim. The next thing we'll do is we'll work an edging all the way up the right front, around the hood, and then down the left front. And to begin, we're going to start on the right front, down in the bottom corner here. So starting on the right front, down here in the corner, into this corner space here, I'm going to attach my yarn. And then I'm going to chain one. And then back into the same space, I'm going to work one half double crochet. And then I'm going to work one half double crochet into the next 20 spaces. So into the next space here. There's one. Two. Three. Four, five, six, and 20. And then we've arrived at the hood area. So into each space, all the way around the hood, we're going to work one half double crochet. So there should be 35 spaces all the way around the hood. So there's one, two, three, four. When you get to the seam area of your hood, it's a bit difficult to see where the spaces are. So where the seam is, you're going to work two half double crochet. So I'll put one in here and then one here. So there's one, and then I'll put one here. So this was number 17, then 18, 19. And then continue working your half double crochet into the spaces. And you should have a total of 35 half double crochet around the hood. Once you've finished working your 35 half double crochet around the hood, you're then going to work one half double crochet into the next 21 spaces, and that will take you all the way down to the bottom of the left front. So there's one, two, three, and 21. You're then going to chain one and turn your work. And for the next row, which is the last row of our edging, you're going to work one half double crochet back into the same space, into this first space here. And then you're going to work one half double crochet into the next 60 spaces. So there's one, two, three, four, five, and 60. And then we're going to make our little buttonhole. So to do this, I'm going to chain two, one and two. And then I'm going to come to the next space and I'm going to work one half double crochet. And you can see I formed my little buttonhole. And I'm just going to get my button here and make sure that it passes through, and it does. So depending on the size of button, you might have to only do one chain or possibly even more. And then we're going to continue working our half double crochet all the way down the right front to the bottom. So we'll work one half double crochet into the next 15 spaces. So there's one, two, three, four, and 15, which is going to go here. So this was the chain one and the first half double crochet. So we'll place it into this space here. So you'll probably have to pull it apart a little bit. And then I'm just going to grab my scissors and cut my yarn. And then I'm just going to weave this little tail in. And this one here, where we attached the yarn. I've just finished weaving in my ends, and as you can see, I sewed a little button onto the right front here. Next, we'll move on and we'll make a couple of ears that we'll attach to our little hoodie. This is, of course, optional. It looks really cute just as it is. But if you would like to learn how to make some ears, then continue watching the video. To begin with the ears, grab your J 6mm crochet hook and make a chain of four. One, two, three, and four. And then into the first chain, you're going to join with a slip stitch to form a ring. And we'll be working our stitches into the middle of the ring. So if you pull it apart, you'll work your stitches in here. So to begin round number one, begin by chaining one. And then we're going to work eight single crochet into the centre of the ring. And make sure you work over this little tail here. So there's one. And I'm just going to insert my stitch marker. and 8. So I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 8 single crochet. And I'm going to join the round by slip stitching into that first single crochet to join. And then I'm just going to grab this little tail at the back and I'm just going to pull on it to close the ring. For round number 2, begin by chaining 1. And then back into the same stitch right at the base of the chain 1. So right in here at the base of the chain 1. I'm going to work 2 single crochet. So there's 1. And then I'll work another single crochet back into the same stitch. And then into the first single crochet, I'll place my stitch marker because this is where we'll be slip stitching into at the end of the round. And then into the next 7 single crochet, I'm going to work 2 single crochet. So there's 1 and then another 1. Back into the same stitch, then into the next stitch, I'll work my 2 single crochet, into the next stitch, 2 single crochet, into the next stitch, 2 single crochet. So at the end of this round, you should have 16 single crochet. So there's 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14 and 16. And then to join the round, I'm going to slip stitch into the first single crochet. For rounds 3 to 4, you're going to work a chain 1 and then you're going to work 1 single crochet into each stitch all the way around. So the first single crochet will be at the base of the chain 1, right in here. So there's 1. Two, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and 16. And then I'll join the round by slip stitching into the first single crochet. And then for the next round, which is round number 4, and it's our last round, we're just going to repeat round number 3. So we'll chain 1 and then we'll work 1 single crochet into that first stitch at the base of the chain 1. And then we'll work one single crochet into the next 15 stitches, and then we'll slip stitch to the first single crochet. So I've just come to the end of round number 4. I'll still have 16 single crochet all the way around, and I'm just going to slip stitch into that first single crochet to join. And then you want to grab your scissors and cut your yarn, but you want to leave a long tail because you'll be sewing this ear onto your little hoodie. So make sure that you leave a decent amount of yarn. Then I'm just going to pull the yarn through. So you want to make, and you can just weave this little end in at the back. And you want to make 2 of these ears. And what we'll do now is I'll show you roughly where I place them on the hoodie. As you can see, I've finished my 2 little ears, and the next thing that we'll do is we'll sew them onto the little hoodie, and you just need to position them where you think looks best, and you may also like to pin them in place with a couple of pins as you sew them to make it easier for you. So position your little ears where you think looks best. I've placed them just above the rolled up brim here, and as you can see, I've pinned them in place, and this is to make it easier when you're sewing them. And there's nothing fancy with the sewing here. You're just going to go in to the hoodie and then come out through part of the ear. And then you'll go back through the hoodie and then back up through the ear. And you'll basically do a few stitches just to secure them. And you might like to work around the back of the ear as well to stop them from flopping around too much. But you don't need to be too neat because this type of yarn, it hides the stitches are not going to be very visible at all. And here's my little hoodie all finished. I really hope that you enjoyed this tutorial. If you liked it, you might like to show some support and give it a thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the little bell icon so you don't miss out on any future videos that I upload. Thanks so much for watching.